Hello everyone, welcome to my class. Hope all of you are doing well. I have already started the third chapter of NCERT book First Flight, Two Stories About Flying, and I am doing the second story, that is Black Peregrine by Frederick Forsyth. In my previous video, I had already given introduction of the author, message of the story, theme, and short summary of the story. If you haven't seen my previous video, I request you to go and please watch my video. And I would also like to request you to subscribe and like my channel and also press the bell icon for notification so that whenever I post a new video, you are notified. And I would also like to thank Google, because all the pictures that you will see in my videos are taken from Google. So let's begin the chapter. In this video, I will be explaining you the chapter paragraph wise. I will read each paragraph and then I will give you the explanation of the paragraphs. Let's begin the first paragraph of the story Black Aeroplane by Frederick Forsyth. The moon was coming up in the east behind me, and stars were shining in the clear sky above me. There wasn't a cloud in the sky. I was happy to be alone high up above the sleeping countryside. I was flying my old Dakota aeroplane over France back in England. I was dreaming of my holiday and looking forward to being with my family. I looked at my watch. 1:30 in the morning. Let's see the explanation. The narrator, who was a pilot, was very fond of flying his Dakota aeroplane at night. Dakota is the name of his aeroplane, that is DS-088. And when he started his flight, it was a very beautiful starry night when the sky was very clear and the stars were twinkling. The narrator or the pilot felt peace in being above a country that had fallen asleep while he was flying over France and England. It was 1:30 in the morning and he was fantasizing about holidaying with his family. He was longing to go to his family. We all love our family and we love to spend our time with them. Let's see the second paragraph. I should call Paris control room, I thought, as I looked down past the nose of the aeroplane. I saw the lights of a big city in front of me. I switched on the radio and said, Paris control, Dakota DS-088 here. Can you hear me? I'm on my way to England. Over. The voice from the radio answered me immediately. DS-088, I can hear you. You ought to turn 12 degrees west now. DS-088, over. So the narrator was flying from France to England, and then when he was about to reach France, he thought of connecting himself with the Paris control room, because they are the one who gives them all the direction which way do they need to turn their aeroplane. So he called them up and said, when the aeroplane was nearer to France, the narrator thought of informing the Paris control personnel about the plane's presence and for their instructions. As he could see the lights from the Paris city were blaring at him. He informed the control agency, to which they replied with further instructions on directions. The control room at Paris instructed him to turn 12 degrees towards the west. So he followed him, he talked to the people from the Paris control room, and they had instructed him to take a 12 degrees west. So he would follow him and the instruction. Let's see paragraph number 3. I checked the map and the compass, switch over to my second and the last Google tab, and I turned the Dakota 12 degrees west towards England. I will be in time for breakfast, I thought. A good big English breakfast. Everything was going well. It was an easy flight. So he was really, really longing to go to his family and spend his time with them, especially having the delicious English breakfast with them. Paris control room gave instructions to the pilot. He geared up and followed them while putting the last fuel tank into operation. He was very happy as he was going to his home and will meet his family. He was dreaming about his time with his family, and then he started thinking about having a satisfactory breakfast at the destination point. And what is the destination point? That is his family, his home, his sweet home. He was peaceful. He was contented. He was satisfied. As why? Because everything was going very well as he planned. He has chalked out. He has planned to fly to his family, have good breakfast. Until now, everything was going so very, very well. So let's see. Well, everything will be okay or not. So let's look at the next paragraph, paragraph number 4. Paris was about 150 kilometers behind me when I saw the clouds, storm clouds. So there is a change in the story. The night was very starry, night was very beautiful, and when he had a talk with the Paris control room, but now he could see little danger. What is the danger? Storm clouds. They were huge. They looked like black mountains standing in front of me across the sky. I knew I couldn't fly up and over them, and I did not have enough fuel to fly around them to the north or south. I ought to go back to Paris, I thought, but I wanted to get home. I wanted that breakfast. I'll take the risk, I thought, and flew that old Dakota straight into the storm. He could face the danger in front of him. He could see the stormy clouds. He understood, he realized that it's not safe for him to go and take the risk. But then he should have returned to Paris. But his longingness to go to his family and have that beautiful breakfast, spend time with his family, had compelled him to take the risk. So he took the risk of flight. Let's see. What is the consequence of taking the risk? As I told you, that this is a story about miracle and mystery. He had crossed Paris. Suddenly, he saw dark black clouds in the sky. The presence of clouds made it unsafe to travel by air because there were chances of a storm. They were so huge and dark that the pilot compared them with black mountains. He knew he couldn't pass them as it was impossible to go above them or escape them with the amount of fuel that was left in the last tank. The right decision would have been to fly back to Paris safely, but the pilot's decision making was trained up by his wish to meet his family. He desperately wanted to be with his family and have that English breakfast he had been dreaming of all day. So he took the risk of not going back and headed the plane right into the storm. So he was a courageous man. He was a very brave man. He was not afraid of danger. He loved to take risk. And moreover, his love for his family was so tremendous that he took the risk. So let's see, who wins? His love for his family or the risk and that he had taken? The result of that risk will be good, or he will face the bad consequences. Miracle will happen or not? Let's see. Paragraph number 5. Inside the clouds, everything was suddenly black. It was impossible to see anything outside the aeroplane. The old aeroplane jumped and twisted in the air. I looked at the compass. I couldn't believe my eyes. The compass was turning round and round and round. It was dead. It could not work. The other instruments were suddenly dead too. I tried the radio. So nothing was actually working for him. In front of him, he could see black cloud. He was engulfed in the black cloud. His apparatus that he had in his bag wasn't working. His compass wasn't working. It was not showing the direction. So let's see what happens. It was very dark because of the storm. Nothing was visible outside the plane. He started losing control of the plane. The compass and other instruments were also not working because of the bad weather. He became helpless. So there he was with his plane, old Dakota DS-088. He was inside the black clouds. Nothing was there. Everything was black. He couldn't see anything. His apparatus were not working. He had no help up in the sky. What shall we do? Shall we overcome this problem? Or what will happen? We will see in my next video. So for today, till here I complete my video, my task, and in my next video I will continue the chapter and I will give you the paragraph wise explanation. Till then, thank you so much for watching my video. Stay safe, stay healthy.